So we're on a rescue mission, and that rescue mission is one day, when, I don't know, but one day you're going to die. It said the soul that sinners shall die, every single one of us is going to die. But it's not the end. One day is the day of resurrection, when we come before Almighty God. And Paul says it is the judgment seat of Christ. It means every paedophile, every murderer is going to come before God, and they're going to get judged by God. But it also means you and I, every sinner, everybody who has broken the law of God is going to be judged. And the big question that will be asked of us is, what did we do with Jesus Christ? What did we do with him who said, I am the light of the world? Who said, I am the way, the life? Who said, I am the bread of life? What did we do with him? Did we believe him when he said, I am the resurrection and the life? Or did we reject him? I said before, and I'll say it again, in 1953, the Queen of England said she would defend the law and the gospel. And our country has rejected the law and the gospel, and we need to get back to what it's all about. And what it's all about is the Son of God who shed his blood and give his life for you and me. That's what it's all about. There's life in him, and there's hope in him, and peace in him. He can change your life. He can change your direction. He can make a way for you. He can give you a hope. Says in the Word of God, the Lord is my shepherd. It doesn't say Wacky Back is my shepherd, Spice is my shepherd, Porn is my shepherd, Drugs is my shepherd, Violence is my shepherd, Materialism is my shepherd. No, it says the Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. And there is nothing to fear if you trust in Jesus. There's nothing to fear if you trust in him. But no matter how great you are, no matter how powerful you are, one day you'll die. One day you'll die, and when you die, it's not the end. The Bible says the blood of Jesus Christ cleanses us from all sin. The Bible says we preach Christ crucified. The Bible says if you confess your sin, he is faithful and just to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. The Bible says in the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. The Bible says that Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. The Bible says, Jesus said, I am the light of the world. The Bible says that Jesus said, whoever is thirsty, let him drink. The Bible says, blessed are the pure in heart. The Bible says, blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake. That if you name the name of Christ and follow Christ, you will be persecuted. You'll be laughed at. You'll be called a Bible basher if you believe the Bible, if you follow Jesus. But what is best? To follow Jesus and be laughed at, or to not follow him and end up in hell? The Bible says, come follow me. Don't follow drugs. Don't follow political correctness. Don't follow this age of madness. This age that is mad. This age is a crazy age. This age has thrown out God. And because this age has thrown out God, it has become an age of anarchy. There are places in London you can't go for a walk at night or else you'll get raped. The old people can't walk at night. We've become an age of anarchy. An age of anarchy, my friend. And it's because we've rejected God. It's because we've thrown out God. There's no respect for the elderly. There's no respect anymore. It's gone out of the window. Why? Because we threw God out of the window. We threw his law out of the window. We threw Christ out of the window. And we threw it out. We threw it out. And what has come in? What has come in? Absolute nonsense. That's what's come in. Absolute sexual immorality, where we have gay marriage and we have all that stuff. That's come in. And that is against the Bible, and it's against the Word of God. And it's because we've thrown out the Bible, we've thrown out the Word of God, and now we've become a nation that doesn't know its left arm from its right arm. We are in a total mess as a nation. We are in a total mess as a nation. And if we don't wake up soon, it's going to get worse and worse. We're in a mess as a nation, and we have to begin to wake up. If we don't wake up, we will wake up, and we will be like Syria, we'll be like Iraq, because we didn't take and heed. We didn't hear the voice of God. The voice of God is telling us right now that we were a Protestant nation, we were a nation under the Bible, and we have rejected our Protestant heritage, and we have rejected our Bible, and now we are in a total mess as a nation. And we as a nation have to repent and come back. The Queen has to uphold her coronation oath, who said that she would defend the Protestant faith. She said she would defend the Bible. She said she would defend the Lord of God, the Gospel. But the Parliament has rejected that. The Parliament set up gay marriage and said, no, we reject the Bible. We don't want to know about the Bible. We'll have gay marriage. We'll have transgender. Forget the Bible. We don't want to know about the Bible. And they have rejected the coronation of the Queen. The Queen said she would uphold the law and the Gospel. She said she would uphold the Protestant faith. And Parliament has said no to her. Parliament has said no to the Bible, no to the living God. Even the Church of England now are thinking of having gay marriage. Why? Because they've rejected the Bible, they've rejected the coronation of the Queen when she said she would uphold the law and the Gospel. And we as a nation, and we in the West, we are crumbling, and we are crumbling fast. There will be anarchy on the streets if you don't repent soon. There will be civil war on the streets in years to come. Why? Because there's no peace for the wicked. There's no peace for the wicked. And if we continue to trample on the Word of God and continue to trample on the heritage that we have had as a nation, a Protestant nation, if we continue to urinated against the wall and say it's not worth anything and call down this gay rights and all this transgender and all this political correct nonsense. If we continue in the West to do this, the West will be no more. There'll be a day when Russia marches into the West. There'll be a day when China marches into the West, because we have no strength anymore, because our God has departed from us. In the Second World War, we had a day of repentance. The King had a day of repentance. The nation had a day of repentance. Churchill had a day of repentance. Our bishops had a day of repentance. Why? They were seeking the help of the living God. Every person in the tank regiment, every person in the Second World War was given a New Testament, a King James New Testament. We were a Protestant nation. But now, we are a nation of Muppets, led by Muppets, and we have become Muppets. We are the laughingstock of the world. We can't even afford ships anymore for our army. We can't even afford to have, what are those ships with the planes going in? What are they called? We can't even afford aircraft carriers. That's how pathetic we are. We have become a laughing stock. We are no longer Great Britain. We are no longer, you can't even say Great Britain anymore in our country. We can't even fly our flag without being ashamed. You can't even hold a St. George's cross in our country without feeling ashamed. Why? Because the political correct brigade have taken over. And they've thrown out God, they've thrown out the Bible, and hey, guess what? The new fascists are in town. The thought brigade's in town. You can't question them, you can't have a different opinion than them. And if you have a different opinion, you're homophobic, you're anti-this, you're anti-that, and lock them up and silence them. And it's the fascism that's come in. The Queen said she would uphold the law and the Gospel. And all I'm preaching today is what she said she would uphold, the law and the gospel. The law trumps political correctness. The law trumps gay rights. The law is above all human morality. The Ten Commandments are for all time. And the Ten Commandments tell you the standard for a nation to live. Our judiciary is a total joke. Our judges are an absolute joke. You can rape someone and you're out after 2 years. If you rape someone, you should be in for 10 years. But today, no, our judiciary is a total joke. If you do the crime, you should do the time. But not today. They're all Muppets. They're all Muppet judges who don't give the proper sentence. And it's because we've departed from the Word of God. We've departed from the Word of God. Strong words, I know. I know what I'm saying is strong. But sometimes when a child is going over the edge and is about to fall over the cliff, do you want me to go, excuse me, don't go over the cliff? Or do you want me to shout, don't go over the cliff, you're going to die? And what I said to you is strong words, but this nation is hurtling over the cliff, and it's hurtling over the cliff fast. It's hurtling over the cliff fast. There is corruption in Parliament. There is corruption in the media. There is corruption everywhere we go today. There is censorship in the media. Censorship in Parliament. People who are real men are not allowed to be men anymore because they're silenced by feminism. And a man can't be a man anymore. A man can't stand up and say no anymore. A man is castrated today because of political correctness, because of feminism and all the nonsense that's coming in our nation and all the nonsense that's come in the West. Be gone with it. Be gone with it. Men stand up, women stand up. It's time to be a man, it's time to be a woman. It's time to lift your voice and say no. Don't be like a Muppet led by Muppets. Lambs to the slaughter. That's what we're living in a land time today. We're lambs led to the slaughter. Please repent. Please come home to Jesus. Come home before it's too late. Forget the Conservative Party. Forget the Labour Party. Forget these political parties. They're all in it together. They ain't going to help you. They're all on the gravy train. They've all been to Heaton and Oxford. They don't care about you. They're leading this nation to hell. They're leading this nation to degradation. You need a better way, and that way is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the way. Jesus Christ will save this nation. But he won't save it unless you call upon him. Unless you say, you know what? Where are we going as a nation? We can't even fly our flag anymore. We're ashamed of being Great Britain. You can't even go to a men's toilet. Because now they switched it, you can go in, a woman can go into a man's toilet and a man can go into a woman's toilet, and everybody's going to be confused and don't know which way they're going. We need to wake up. We need to wake up. This political correctness is killing the nation. It's killing the West. And this nation was a nation of the Bible once. In this nation, every man and woman in this nation used to have a King James Bible and the Foxy Book of Martyrs and Pilgrim's Progress. That was what was in every home 50 years ago. You wouldn't even know what the Foxy's Book of Martyrs is today. You wouldn't, I'm not saying, I'm telling you the truth and you need to hear it. You need to hear it. You need to hear it. But maybe the Fascist Brigade are coming. Maybe the Fascist Brigade are going to come and silence the voice. But if they do, I'm still going to say it. This nation is under judgment. This nation is going to come more under judgment and more under judgment until this nation repents. This nation had a queen that said she would stand for the gospel and the Lord of God. And this nation has rejected the gospel. And this nation has rejected the law. It's time you repent, and it's time you come back to the gospel. Jesus is waiting. My friends, it's all over if you don't repent. You gotta turn to the Lord while you can. Turn, He offers you life. He offers you peace. He offers you joy. He offers you salvation. When I survey the wondrous cross on which the Prince of Glory died, He offers you salvation. Please wake up. Please come to Christ. Please come out of this system of the world and come to Jesus today. Please hear the gospel while you can. Hear the gospel. Hear the good news that Jesus saves. The good news that Jesus is alive. The good news that Jesus can set you free. The good news that Jesus will bless you with salvation if you turn to Him. That is the good news. And He offers it to you. He forgives 70 times 7. If we mess up as a nation, He'll forgive us. If we mess up individually, He'll forgive us. But if we continue to reject Him, if we continue to stample on His word and reject the preachers of the word in the towns and the cities of this land, if we continue to reject it, then this nation will be torn apart and it will be splattered upon the four corners of the winds and it will be no more. So please hear the call. You've been warned. You've been warned 1,000 times. Hear the call. God is calling you to turn to Him and come to Him while you can. Find His love and salvation today. Find His grace and His mercy and His blessing. Find His peace and joy in your life and salvation. Find it today while you can. God bless you.